Hey everyone, and welcome to another TFT guide. To be honest, I was preparing an in-depth sharpshooter guide, but 10.21 came out, and with it, a super OP build rise. I saw some streamers saying it's free LP, but I had to try it myself. Of course, you have guessed it. We'll talk about Divine Comp. Before I even managed to get the hang of it, I just streamrolled my way into Masters without even trying. So today, we are gonna be taking a look at this new awesome build, but we'll keep it simple because it's too early in the patch and I want you guys to get it up and running as soon as possible for some free LP. If you guys wanna climb the ladder easily and before the others make out what's working and what's not, stick around. We'll talk about general playstyle of the comp, we'll refer to some variations, the early, mid and late game stages, items and general tips and tricks that can make the difference when you play this build. Make sure you use this comp as right now is the most free LP comp I have ever seen since the TFT launch. Before we dive in, if you like this kind of guide, take a second to subscribe, like and hit that notification bell just so you know when I upload new videos. So without further ado, these are the core units. You don't actually need 8 Divine, you don't even need 6 Divine, and that's why you power spike with this build really early. I even got an 11 win streak in a Masters lobby with 4 Divine base. The best thing about this comp is that it's very flexible. You can use many variations depending on what chosen you get, and most of them are S tier. All you need is 4 Divine with chosen or not and a stacked Warwick. At this point, I want to mention two things. The items shown in the graph are all viable and are sorted by best to worst from right to left. The ones that are essential for the build to work are on red. Secondly, you can win the lobby with 4 Divines easily, so don't tunnel into Divines that much. I'm telling you, all you need is Warwick and 4 Divines active. With all that said, let's take a quick look to variations so you can visualize your late game. This is the S tier variant of the build. It utilizes the 8 Divines, but you need a Divine Chosen and a Sword of the Divine, so unless I have an early spatula and a great early game, I wouldn't tunnel into this build, but getting that is an almost an instant win. As always, the Chosen dictates the variation. So if you get an early Divine, of course you should never drop your Divine Chosen, I would only drop Chosen Wukong and only if I had the level 7 Lee Sin before the roll down. At this point, I want to mention that right now Lee Sin is completely busted, even with no items and even 1 star. He does kick carries out of the board, just instantly get him inside once you see him in the shop. His best items are the ones shown in the graph. I have compiled the Hunter variation, actually this variation got me to Masters without even repositioning at all. Again, that's an S tier variant and it's mostly used if you get a Nash or a Kindred Chosen in the level 7 roll down. Hunters are very good after the buff, so consider using them. Last variant is the Enlightened Chosen. Again, S tier, again same base for Divines. I have tried that with Morgana, with Talon, even with Jaina, but of course for this build, best chosen is Irelia. Irelia is a core unit for all variants, and getting her chosen is a no-brainer. Of course, our best chosen is Warwick, but I don't think that needs explanation. So, early game. The general idea is to fast 8, enroll for Warwick, and Lee Sin, plus to start the rest of your board. In order to do that, in early game you have to get 4 Divines up and running as soon as possible. The 4 Divine on its own will stabilize you, let you econ into mid game and get to level 8 without a need to roll and stabilize. Of course, that's not a rule, you have to measure your board and scout to evaluate the lobby, plus you need to know that right now Divines are like 6 out of 10 players going for them every lobby. So you will have to scout, and if you see many going for Divines, you go ahead and roll at level 7 to get your Warwick before the others. Finding the Divine candidates is super easy, you just look at their items, if you see sieves and QSS, but mostly sieves, they are going for your precious big bad wolf. So what I consider the easiest early board to transition into Divines is this. Yasuo is an excellent item carrier for Warwick and one of the best early game units. Just get him in a far side and leave him alone to tear the early boards apart. Sieve is also one of the best, if not the best early item right now, so just slam it on an early carry and you are good to go. In mid game, as we already mentioned, you own your 4 Divines. Irelia plus Jaina are here to stay, and in combination with the 4 Divines, they provide the smoothest mid game I have ever seen in the past 3 sets. So after Krags, you should have completed a Sieve, and you can either itemize your Jax or Irelia with tank items, and the comp should be completely stable. Lux will do all the work stunning everyone, with the rest clearing the board. She doesn't need any items to pop off, so don't get baited into itemizing her, she is super OP even completely naked. After Ghouls and the two mid-game carousels, you should be looking to complete your Warwick's items, and I would prioritize any spatulas in these carousels, since getting the Sword of Divine opens up many, many options. Again, I can't stress enough that tunneling into 8 duelists isn't the way to play this build. Imagine your build like this. You need your 4 Divine to be stable. You want your 6 Divine at level 8 if you got your Divine chosen from level 7 or 8 roll down, and you just happen to get to 8 Divine if you high roll big time, but it's not at all needed. Okay, before we dive into itemization, let's take a quick look on the best chosen you can have for this build. Every Divine chosen but Wukong is better than anything else, with best being Warwick, then Jax, then Irelia and Lux. Then it's the Hunter variations, with Ashe and then Kindred chosen. Then it's Enlighter Irelia and maybe Morgana or Talon if you want to be alternative. You can also use Mystic or Adept chosen, but as I mentioned, that's a basic guide and I will make an in-depth one once the dust settles. Okay, let's take a closer look into items. QSS is the prerequisite for Warwick, since we cannot afford to be crowd controlled during a session. I know a session clears SE, but this set is all about crowd control and we can't afford back-to-back stuns that will net our Warwick useless. Other than that, double Sieve is exceptional, Sieve plus Deathblade also works, actually any DPS item work. Just make sure you prioritize his items. Ziggs and Locket are exceptional for this build, as most of the time you will all-in frontline, so make them when you are done with Warwick's items. Tips and tricks. Okay, this guide has gone longer than I expected. Most of the tips and tricks I already mentioned in the sections above, so we just get to summarize the key features for this build. 4 Divine 2 stars with Warwick will net you top 4 and probably win. Lux is the key unit, just keep her in the corner and she will disable the whole opponent board indefinitely. Your win condition for this comp is just good items on Warwick and a 2-star board. Maybe, in very late game, an itemized Lee Sin 2-star. The comp right now is super contested and I'm afraid it will get hotfixed really soon. Hopefully you can take advantage of this guide and climb the ladder before it gets more talked. As always, tell me in the comment section below how did you do with Divines. If you like this video, take a second to subscribe, like and hit that notification bell, and I will see you all in the next one.